Posterior muscles here. Musculus gluteus maximus, musculus gluteus medius, and musculus gluteus minimus. Next, musculus piriformis. Number 22, musculus obturatorius internus, above and below, 20 and 29, musculi gemelli, that is twins muscles, and last muscle, musculus quadratus femoris. Musculus piriformis pass through great ascitic foramen. Do you remember? Foramen ischiaticum majus, and divides this opening into two. Foramen suprapiriforme, above of piriform muscle, and foramen infrapiriforme, below of piriform muscle. Next, go to body. Anterior muscles of pelvic girdle are look here. This muscle, it is musculus psoas, psoas major. Musculus psoas major. All this fossa fossa iliaca occupy with musculus iliacus, and together musculus iliacus and musculus psoas major together formed one muscle, and this muscle leaves pelvic cavity through below of inguinal ligament. And name of this muscle together, iliacus and musculus psoas major together, form musculus iliopsoas. And this space where this muscle leaves abdominal cavity is lacuna musculorum. Lacuna musculorum. I draw you diagram next and you will see. Muscles of the thigh. Anterior, medial and posterior group. Anterior group. First muscle, musculus sartorius. It's a very long muscle which starts from spina iliac anterior superior and attach near medial condyle of the tibia and tuberosus tibia. Next muscle, quadriceps, musculus quadriceps femoris. Today you already know biceps, triceps, and now quadriceps. It consists of four muscles. Musculus rectus femoris, musculus vastus lateralis, vastus it is wide muscle, wide, vastus lateralis, it is vastus medialis, and here musculus vastus intermedius. Next, medial group, and it is musculus pectinus. It starts from pubic bone and go to linea pectinea on the femur. Do you remember linea pectinea? Mm-hmm. It is musculus pectinus. Next three muscles are musculus adductor longus, below musculus adductor brevis, and musculus adductor magnus. One again, adductor longus, then adductor brevis, and it is adductor magnus, and it is musculus gracilis. And last group, posterior muscles of the thigh. Look here. Posterior muscles are biceps, musculus biceps femoris. It consists of long head and short head. That is short, and it is long head of biceps, musculus biceps femoris. And last two muscles, that is musculus semitendinosus. Semitendinosus. Semi, it is half. Half part of this muscle has long narrow tendon, semitendinosus. And last muscle, musculus semimembranosus. Half part of this muscle has wide tendon which look like membrane, semimembranosus. That is musculus semimembranosus and semitendinosus and biceps. In popliteal fossa, present musculus popliteus, but impossible to see it. Only you can read about this muscle, musculus popliteus. That is one muscle of pelvic girdle. It's absent on diagrams, but we can see here musculus tensor fasciae latae. Here it is. A fascia which surround muscles of the thigh has name fasciae latae. And this fascia, laterally, has very thick part. And this part has name tractus iliotibialis. And muscle which tends this tract has name musculus tensor fasciae latae. Here it is, musculus tensor fasciae latae. Now, some words about topography. On the thigh, necessary to know triangle, trigonum femorale. Walls of this triangle, look here. Trigonum femorale has three walls. Superior wall, it is inguinal ligament. Lateral wall, musculus sartorius. And medial wall, musculus adductor longus. In this triangle, we can see two grooves. First groove is between musculus iliopsoas and musculus pectinus. That is why name of this groove, sulcus iliopectinus. It is vessels, femoral artery and femoral vein pass. Sulcus iliopectinus. And downward, this groove continue into another. Sulcus femoris anterior. It's between musculus sartorius and musculus adductor longus. Sulcus femoris anterior. And then this groove, sulcus femoris anterior, continue into the canal. And name of this canal, canalis adductorius, adductorius. Walls of this canal, lateral wall, it is musculus vastus medialis. Medial wall, it is musculus adductor magnus. And anterior wall of this canal, it is fascia which pass from adductor magnus to vastus medialis, and name of this wall, lamina vasto adductoria. Lamina vasta adductoria, it is part of fasciae latae between these two muscles, between vastus medialis and adductor magnus. And this canal, canalis adductorius, open into popliteal fossa. Do you know about inguinal hernia? Sometime maybe femoral hernia. And in this case, when femoral hernia take place, in human body appear femoral canal. In normal, femoral canal is absent. Only when we have femoral hernia, in this case, may be present femoral canal. What present in normal? In normal present only space below inguinal ligament. Here it is. And name of this space below of inguinal ligament, it is annulus femoralis. Annulus femoralis, it is in normal. And in normal present fissure, fissura, or hiatus in superficial layer of fasciae latae. Name of this hiatus, hiatus saphenus. These two structures, annulus femoralis and hiatus saphenus, they are present in normal, in everybody. But when femoral hernia appear, intestine together with peritoneum pass from femoral ring, pass between superficial and deep layer of fasciae latae, and leave canal through superficial opening hiatus saphenus. And in this case, we speak about femoral canal. Anterior wall of this canal, it is superficial layer of fasciae latae. Posterior wall, it is deep layer of fasciae latae. And lateral wall, it is femoral vein. Now take your places and I draw at the blackboard small diagram.